Hey guys, today we will discuss about the construction sequence of each and every component of girder bridge step by step by making a 3D model. Girder bridge is a bridge structure that uses girders as the means of supporting its deck. In the beginning of work, set out the pile points accurately based on the drawing available at site. These vertical structural elements are called as pile, which is driven deep into the ground to transmit loads from substructure through the water and weak soil to the lower level of strong and hard subsoil. The rectangular concrete blocks above the group of piles showing in the model is called as pile cap. Pile cap is a slab above the piles which combine all piles to act as a single member which withstand the load and distribute the loads of structure into all piles. This is a compression member of bridge called as pier. Pier is a raised intermediate support of bridge structure that rises above the body of water. Usually provides above water access for both passengers and cargo. This is the pier cap with pedestal. Pier cap is designed to distribute concentrated loads evenly over the area of the pier. Usually provides sufficient seating space for the bridge girders. And those are called as pedestal. This is the model of a wall-type abutment. Abutment is a substructure component that supports the end of superstructure and transfers the loads from superstructure to pile cap. These are the weave holes in abutment, allows the water of backfill soil to flow through it, which reduces the hydrostatic pressure of backfill material. This process ultimately decreases the earth pressure of backfill retained by abutment. The pedestals acts as a platform for bearing, provided vertical clearance between pier cap and bottom of girder for allowing the movements, which is showing in the top of the abutment and surface of the pier cap. This is the another wall type abutment, showing in the other side. This is the critical element of overall bridge system called as bearing, which provided for allow the permitted movements, to prevent non-permitted undesirable movements, and to transfer the load from superstructure to substructure. The wall showing here in the backside of abutment is called as dirt wall. Dirt wall is required to be provided to prevent the dirt or earth from the approaches spilling on the bearing. These are I-girders, which are the main superstructure components of a girder bridge. The secrets behind the strength of the I and box girder we have already discussed in the previous video. The link is in the description below. This is the final superstructure member called as a bridge deck. Having two-lane carriageway for traffic movement. And this is parapet wall of the bridge deck provided to prevent the vehicles and pedestrians from falling off. And the gap between the deck is called as expansion joint, which allows the movement of superstructure due to thermal expansion and contraction, live loads, seismic activity, etc. In the next video, we will discuss the function of major components of the bridge in detail. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and click on the bell to turn on the notification.